Hello everyone, today we learn about the semiconductor detector. Okay, this one is the last point of this chapter, semiconductor detector. Semiconductor detectors may be called as a solid state ionization chamber. See, semiconductor detectors also called solid state ionization chambers. Solid state ionization chamber. Ionization chamber. Okay. See, why it is called a solid state ionization chamber? Because instead of a gas, which is used as a working substance in GM counter ionization chamber, in this detector, semiconductors are used as a working substance. See, why it is called a solid state? Because in semiconductor detectors, semiconductors are used as a working substance. Then, what are the semiconductors? Give the name of the semiconductors. What are the semiconductors? Semiconductors are the lies between conductors and insulators. Okay. For example, silicon, germanium. These are the semiconductors. The band gap energy in case of semiconductors is in the order of 1 electron volt. The band gap energy is about the 1 electron volt. So, when an energetic particle passes through a semiconductor material like a silicon or germanium, it knocks out an electron from the silicon or germanium. That is, lifts an electron from the valence band to the conduction band. See, in silicon germanium, these are the semiconductors. Their band gap energy is about the 1 electron volt. Okay, so when an energetic particle is given to the alpha particle passes through a semiconductor material like a silicon and germanium, it knocks out an electron from the silicon, that is, lifts an electron. There is a valence band, this is the conduction band. Okay, when an energetic particle passes through the semiconductor material, what happens? It knocks out an electron from the valence band to the conduction band. This is the valence band and there is a electron. Okay, this electron leaps towards the conduction band. Okay, and here is the electron, and this position of the electron is called as a hole. See, when an energetic particle passes through a semiconductor material like a silicon or germanium, it knocks out an electron from the silicon or germanium, that is, lifts an electron from the valence band to the conduction band. Thus, an electron in conduction band and a hole, that is the absence of electron in the valence band, are the charge carriers created in the semiconductor. These are the charge created in the semiconductors having hole and electron. Okay, which is equivalent to the ionization of the medium. This is called the ionization of the medium. By applying an external voltage across the semiconductor, an ion current pulse can be generated and hence the ionizing particle can be detected. See, by applying an external voltage across the semiconductor, an ion current pulse will be generated and hence the ionizing particle can be detected. Okay, this one is about the semiconductor detector. Then, for a efficient detection of a PN junction diode is employed. See, however, for a efficient detection of the particles, PN junction diode is employed. When a PN junction is formed, the electrons in the N region, see what happens in the PN junction. See the diagram. Okay. For efficient detection of particles, a p-n junction diode is employed. When a p-n junction is formed, the electrons in n region migrate into the p region. See what happens? There is a n region. This one is the n region having electrons and p region having a positive charge. Okay, there is a depletion region between the n region and p region. See, roughly I can draw here. This one is the n region, this one is the p region. Okay, there is a, this one is the depletion layer. Okay, p having a positive charges and n having negative. Then see what happened. When a p-n junction is formed, the electrons in the n region, these electrons in n region migrate into the p region. These are migrated towards the p region and neutralize the holes, positive charge carriers in p region, and it get neutralized with the positive charge carriers in p region. Therefore, n region acquires a positive potential. This n region acquires a positive potential and the p region is at negative potential. Okay, what happens? These electrons migrated towards the p region, and instead of a, in absence of electrons, there is a hole, and hence the n region is at positive potential. And by the from the n region, the electrons migrated in p region, and there is a electrons having a negative charge, and hence the p region have a negative potential. Thus, a small potential difference called a barrier potential difference, called a barrier potential difference, is established, which opposes the migration of charges across the junction. See, this potential difference opposes the migration of charges across the junction. Finally, the migration stops a small barrier potential difference. About a hole is developed as shown in figure. The thickness of the depletion layer from where the charge carriers are removed, it is very small, like less than mm. The thickness of depletion layer can be increased considerably by reverse biasing the junction. See, the thickness of the depletion layer can be increased considerably by reverse biasing the junction. As the reverse bias assists the barrier potential difference, like reverse bias voltage of several volt are employed to obtain a depletion layers of a few mm thickness. Okay, this is regarding the p-n junction. Then we can see the construction and working of a semiconductor detectors. Okay, a large p-type silicon crystal is selected and to form. See what is the construction of semiconductor detector. A large p-type silicon crystal is selected, and to form an n region on face of a crystal, a donor impurity like phosphorus is diffused at a high temperature. Soon a depletion layer is created at the junction. A reverse bias voltage about 100 to 1000 volts is applied across the junction, due to which the thickness of the depletion layer becomes fairly large. See, a large p-type silicon crystal is selected. And to form a n region on face of the crystal, a donor impurity like a phosphorus is diffused at a high temperature. P-type silicon crystal is selected, and n-type donor impurity like a phosphorus is diffused at a high temperature. Okay. Soon a depletion layer is created at the junction. See, In PN junction, there is a depletion layer. This one is the N region, this one is the P region. P region is silicon crystal and N region is the phosphorus, donor impurity like phosphorus. Okay. Then when the PN junction form, there is a depletion region. And depletion region remove the charge carriers. Okay. Hence, the depletion layer is created at the junction so that a reverse bias voltage is about 100 to 1000 volts is applied across the junction, due to which the thickness of the depletion layers becomes fairly large, okay, about a few mm. Okay. When an ionizing particle enters the depletion region, electron hole pairs are created at expense of the energy of the particle. Under the influence of a strong reverse bias voltage, these charge carriers are quickly drifted towards the electrons, that is, the holes towards the negative electrodes and electron towards the positive electrodes. Though the electrons and holes are moving in opposite directions, they constitute a current in the same direction, which produces a current pulse, which can be amplified and recorded. See what happens. Here we use P-type silicon crystal and N-type a donor impurity like phosphorus. Okay. And the depletion layer becomes fairly large by using a reverse bias voltage. Okay. See, then what happens when an ionizing particle enters the depletion region, electron hole pair is created. See, this one is the depletion layer. Okay. This one N, this one is the P. The electrons from the N region get migrated towards the P region. Okay. This one is the depletion layer. When an ionizing particle enters the depletion region, electron and hole pairs are formed, positive and negative. This electron hole pairs are created at the expense of the energy of the particle under the influence of a strong reverse bias voltage. These charge carriers are quickly drifted towards the electrodes, that is, holes towards the negative electrode and electrons towards the positive electrode. Electrons, see, holes towards the negative electrode and electron towards the positive electrode. Though the electrons and holes are moving in opposite directions, they constitute a current in the same direction, which produces a current pulse. This, see, holes are accelerated towards the negative electrode and electron towards the positive electrodes. Though the electrons and holes are moving in opposite direction, they constitute a current which produces in a same directions, okay, which produces a current pulse which can be amplified and further it can be recorded. It may be noted that the time of flight of the charges is of the order of a few nanosecond. Okay. And hence, the counting speed of semiconductor detector is very high. See, this one is the important. The counting speed of semiconductor detector is very high because the time of flight of charges is of the order of few nanosecond. Hence, the counting speed of the semiconductor detector is very high. The energy only about the 3 electron volt, the energy required is about the 3 electron volt is the required to produce a pair of ions, that is the electron hole pair. And if the ionizing particle is stopped in the depletion layer, then the strength of the current, that is the pulse height, is proportional to the initial energy of the particle. See, the pulse height is proportional to the initial energy of the particle. Some covalent bonds are broken, that is the electron hole pairs are created due to the thermal agitation which creates a noise signal. This noise can be reduced by operating the device at low temperature. If the proper signal is weak, see, some covalent bonds are broken, that is the electron and holes pair are created due to the thermal agitation which creates a noise. Okay, this noise can be reduced by operating the device at low temperatures if the proper signal is weak. Secondly, the light incident on the depletion layer can be produce a unwanted signal, that is the noise. To avoid this, device may be operated in complete darkness. Okay, these are the two precautions we have to take. Okay, here we completed the semiconductor detectors and the chapter. Okay, in next class we learn the next chapter. Thank you.